And we are back again, getting ready for the war with Sweden, I believe, because, yeah, last episode we finally... He's a crusader. Isn't that brilliant? And everybody loves him. Well, good for him. I don't really care. So, claim. Oh my. Oh, it includes these holdings. Oh, that is awesome. Oh well. Yep. There we go. War has been declared. Still working on getting rid of this gal, but that doesn't really matter. Army levies are standing too. I'm gonna rely mostly on my vassal levies. I don't really care enough to get involved personally. Well, that's not true entirely. That's not true at all. That is absolutely a blatant lie. I care a lot about this war. This is the war I've been waiting for the last... I don't know how many episodes, but quite a few. So this is gonna be... This might be the war that ends the playthrough for at least the first season. So, if we win this, then we're able to form up the Empire of Scandinavia, then I will have accomplished what I set out to do in the first season. That is really cool. So, fingers crossed, eh? Anyway... See where we are. Really? I've got fleets everywhere but where I need them. Yeah, okay. It's fine, I guess. Yeah, I'm gonna move everything. Everything to Evra. Kidding me. Room to spare. Speaking from experience. We might as well just move everything like so. You guys will be able to pick up him. You guys... Actually, everybody just move here. And then these guys can do that too. Yeah, we'll move spare army over there as well. You can just go there immediately. And with you. Now. Start forming up what will become the southern end of this Swedish invasion armada. You get on board. Just walk there. Board. You go there. Go there. Small part of it. Go there. Small part of it. You go there. Wow, 24 soldiers? Really? Okay. So you all can just head over here then. You're waiting for pickup. And that'll be actually not enough. That's interesting. Go there. You can go there. You can get aboard it. Go there. Go there. Okay. So, why don't you just go there as well? These ships on their way. Nope. Okay. Yeah, you. Of all things. Just go there. So that should be just about it. You know what? This plot just turned different. I'm gonna refrain from doing anything silly right now. Whatever. I'm gonna call in my allies. They're not gonna do anything. Recognize that I have an unlanded son and I have lots of sons and I have lots of de jure claims. I don't care. Righteously imprison a number of people. Grand Mayor, he kinda likes me. This guy likes me. Not so much. Jesus, there are lots of people like in prison. I'm gonna get back to you on all this. I'm gonna do that right before I die. See how this works out. Lots of stuff under siege. That is to be expected. Anything interesting going on? Nope. I have to consolidate my forces until I understand what's going on fully here. Your tales are okay. My wife has agreed to help me. Raw, I guess. That is a good thing. Other than that, okay, for those of you who are easily bored, I'm going to do this by the book because this is a fairly important war. So be prepared for micromanagement in the classic Crusader Kings style. I'm gonna make sure I move all my armies correctly. I really, really, really want to get this right. Because if I win this war swiftly and quickly and easily and professionally, I will be in a very good position to continue the game. So, I'm gonna be doing everything as well as I know how. To say it's gonna be perfect, but it's gonna be as perfect as I can get it. Now, that also means my commentary is probably going to go downhill a bit, because I'm gonna be thinking more than I'm gonna be talking. And there is also the fact that I am drinking, so just live with it. Deal, alright? And that's what Jesse Cox would say. He's my idol. Him and Damo and Total Biscuit. No, Total Biscuit is not my idol. He's a bit of a jackass, but he's a very, very funny jackass, and I really, really like the way he casts. I don't even like StarCraft 2 all that much, but I really love watching him play and watching him commentate on it. So yeah, that was a bit of a random thing. Okay. Just looking for stuff to merge, looking for stuff to micromanage. These guys are now, oops. Get a board there and go over there just in case we're running out of supply or running out of ships. Merge. Get on board. Said get on board. I thought as much. So there is that. You guys merch. You guys. Get aboard. Okay. So there is that settled. Where are you guys going? You guys are going nowhere fast. Slowly, rather. Just start heading over here. Merge these guys. Merge these. Let's see. For those of you who are curious about my battle plan, it's going to be fairly similar to all the other ones I've had when I've invaded Sweden. I'm going to have armies moving up from the south. And then I'm going to make a landing in the center somewhere to try to knock out their supplies. Come on. 8th of August. Oh. Scottish aren't helping. That's actually a bit of a disappointment. I would have thought they actually would have sort of made an effort. Huh. Oh well. This is a main army, so it's gonna go up here. Can I land? Nope. You guys, how about you just rally here? Fourteen 14,000 men, run ashore. Can I usurp a title? No, I have unlanded sons, that's what that means. Okay, and I landed without leaders. I'm an idiot. Why did I do that? You guys head back there, see if you can. I'm gonna bring in everything I can for this war. 35,000 troops? Really? Okay then. I'm just gonna drop them up here and split them in two. Yeah. So 15,000, yep. They're gonna go here. When home is under siege, that is absolutely fine. It's not like it's gonna matter that I drop these here without leaders. I'm still gonna mop the floor with it, everybody they encounter. I'm gonna pursue that army. And where are you going? Everybody else is going somewhere. Except you. You go there then. Ah, an underhanded rogue. And she's a lesbian. My niece, my 16-year-old lesbian niece. She's brave, humble, charitable, content, and honest. She seems like a wonderful human being. That is just adorable. Let's see if we can find you a nice... I know you're lesbian, so you don't really want to get married, but considering this... Whoa. Yeah, you're not gonna get married to him. Considering the social circumstances, let's say, oh, nobody will do a matrilineal one. Let's do it the other way around. Okay, let's... Let's see if we can find you a young gay lad, eh? Nope. Okay, let's just get the ranking one. So Baron is the best you can do. Let's get you a Baron then. A Russian one or an Italian one? This one seems nice. There we go. Where was I? Lot of men. Yeah, trade posts, my ass. I don't care. Okay. That whole 206 ships thing. The betrothal is okay, fine. Another victory. 21 days, you go to shore and then stand down, because I'm not going to pay for that fleet to run about. I'm a bit concerned about this blobbing. Then again, I'm blobbing too, so... You're going straight there to pick up them. You're going straight there to pick up them. You're moving in there. Okay, you really should split into two armies. Because there's nowhere that's going to be able to hold you. Okay, our holding is under siege, that's fine. 20 something days, you need to split up, man. I'll move 5,000, 6,000, 10,000 north. And then I'll move 10,000 south. This is huge. And other than that, you guys jump ashore. Seven days. Like that. Okay. Just cleaning up the holdings, and that means I need to pause the game here, and I will continue later on. So, cheers and thanks for watching.